So I was fired, but I was triumphant because now I was embarking on my dream job. I was going to be a professional stand-up comedian. Cut to 1994. The stand-up comedy boom has gone stand-up comedy bust. No one wants to see stand-up comedy anymore. It's not on TV anymore. All the clubs have closed down. All the bars have taken the microphones out of the corners. I had no work. I had no prospects of work. And I thought, okay, well, if I'm going to start struggling again, I might as well do it someplace warm. So I moved to Los Angeles, where I did not know a soul. And I very quickly burned through my stake of $200. And I knew what I had to do, but I really didn't want to do it. I knew I had to get a day job again. I knew this was going to be tough because I had already burned through all of my retail goodwill. Because you start out retail thinking you like people, but then very quickly you see the true ugly face of humanity. You stay at a retail job for too long, and you start talking to customers like this. Yeah, sir, I already told you, it's in aisle 3. I can't pick you up and carry you over there. That's poor service. So I'd passed that point a long time ago, right? Then layer onto that, I'd had a taste of doing what I wanted to do for a living. That was taken away from me. So now I was so full of self-loathing, I had to direct it outward at the world. Surely this is someone else's fault. So I got a job at another video store, arrived there bitter, got a job at a video store, sitting there, back behind a counter, full of self-loathing, making it other people's problem. Just couldn't make this fun for myself anymore. So I started stealing. That really livened things up at the old workplace. Worked like a charm. I stole videotapes. I prided myself at the time that I only stole merchandise. I did not steal money from the register. I was no common thief, you see. I was a gentleman bandit. Stealing these wares and giving them to my friends. And it was all to get back at this store who had committed the sin of hiring me, right? So whenever I'd be at work and I was feeling bitter, I'd like steal a videotape, like, that's what you get, video store. That'll teach you. So time passes, I'm not getting any less bitter, and I'm also not getting caught, so eventually, I'm stealing 2 to 3 videos a shift. Every time I walked into that store, I would walk out with a few movies, right? I would get there 5 minutes early for work, and I'd walk up and down the aisles. I was shopping, just like everybody else. It's like, what it looks good to me tonight? What looks bad? Who cares? You cannot beat the price. So my girlfriend at the time was becoming very concerned that I was going to get caught, as the stack on the coffee table was growing higher and higher. She said, I don't know, this is bad. You're gonna get caught. I said, honey, you don't understand. This is all taken care of. And in my mind it was, because one day I'd overheard two of my colleagues talking, and the one said to the other, well, you know, they expect you to steal in retail. That's why they pay you so little. This is all my bitter ears needed to hear. Oh, I didn't realize there was an arrangement. I have been woefully lax in upholding my end of the bargain. Allow me to rectify this toot sweet. So I say to my girlfriend, honey, don't you know about the arrangement in retail? They expect you to steal, that's why they pay you so little. I got this all figured out. If they catch me, it's no big deal. Here's what's gonna happen. Let's role play it. You be the manager, I'll be me. She says, we know you've been stealing videotapes. I say, oh, I will not work for any company who accuses me of being a thief. you may consider this my resignation. I'm out of there. They get rid of the guy who's stealing stuff. I get to save face. It's all part of the arrangement. A year goes by. I am doing this for a year. One day the manager calls me into his office. Have a seat. We know you've been stealing videotapes. Ah, the moment has been prepared for. I knew exactly what to do. Now, admittedly, I was not expecting this to happen today, so it was a little off my game. I did not go into my plan right away. I had to improvise in the moment. So what I did was, I immediately broke eye contact. And I sent a hot rush of blood to my face and ears. Because that's when I remembered that stealing is wrong. All the time. I couldn't justify this in any way. I did not have a bunch of babies at home who ate videotapes. I was just mad because I had to have a job. Certainly it's not part of any business model, right? There's no one that starts a business that says, what do we do if people steal from us? I don't know, pay them less? Ooh, you're good at business. So as the manager watched, I was made to write and sign a confession. This is some classic getting yelled at stuff. I might as well be in my Catholic school uniform, right? Dear video store, I am heartily sorry for having offended thee. Please don't be mad. I want to go to heaven. So I turn in my confession, and I go to leave. And then I am just bombarded by all these thoughts. You know, what am I doing with my life? I wanted to do stand-up comedy. Now I'm being fired for stealing from a place. Who am I? What am I doing? What is happening? So as I'm having this existential crisis, the manager says, and hey, don't ever come back. I think I got it. I think when I was writing out, I stole stuff from here, it dawned on me I was probably not welcome back anytime soon. Believe me, I will not be showing up here in a week's time. Well, I'm assuming that's all blown over. What's up? It's me, the guy who got fired for stealing stuff from here. Anything good or new releases? Keep an eye on me. Ha, 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 ha.